But first this morning, the civil unrest in England has claimed the lives of three young men. The trio was killed trying to defend shops in Birmingham from looters. It comes as police slowly start to regain control of the streets of London. 10's Europe correspondent Brett Mason filed this report just moments ago.
Good morning, Natasha. 16,000 police, an unprecedented number of officers are on the streets here in London following yet another night of violence, not just here in London, but further north in the cities of Manchester and Birmingham. Once again, residents are out on the streets policing their suburbs, ensuring that rioters and looters are turned away. There have been three deaths so far for the first 4 days of this unrest. Despite the huge amount of violence across this country, there has been no fatalities. Today, three lives were lost when young people took to the streets to defend their families.
As London burned for 4 days, remarkably, there was no loss of life. But overnight, a triple tragedy on the streets of Birmingham. Three young men fatally run down as they tried to protect their community from looters.
So I started CPR on my own son. My face was covered in blood. My hands were covered in blood. Why? Why?
There is growing anger that residents are having to police their own streets. We spent the night with one so-called anti-riot squad in London's West.
It doesn't matter what race you are, what background you're from, everyone's got together to defend our area, Southall.
Within minutes, volunteers had detained three young men suspected of looting the local grocery store. This primary school teacher, among the first of more than 1,100 people charged over the riots to face court.
I want them to go to prison for 10 years. I really do. I think they should go to prison for 10 years and they can have a good old think about what they've done to other people.
This was Lance Chinian's home at the height of the riots. His Tottenham apartment complex survived the blitz, but was gutted in minutes by teenagers armed with petrol bombs.
I don't even know what to think. Originally I thought they were like animals, but I think animals aren't that bad. And we just need to stop making excuses for these people. People need to take responsibility for their action and accept that this is all wrong. It shouldn't be happening to just innocent people. You know, somebody easily could have died in that building.
Tonight, 16,000 police remain on the streets. Like all Londoners, they are hoping for the best, but once again preparing for the worst. In London, Brett Mason, 10 News.